Hey everyone, and welcome back to Swift Guitar Lessons for a special talk called 10 Reasons Why You Suck at Guitar. Now, this is just a funny title, it's not supposed to be nasty in any way. Really what I'm going to be doing is thinking back through the last 10 years of my teaching career and address some of the common issues that keep aspiring musicians from reaching their full potential. Let's get started. Okay, first up we have lack of practice. This is the most common reason, but also the easiest to correct. So how do you find more time, more motivation to practice? Well, it's a matter of having better time management skills, prioritizing your guitar playing, and also integrating the guitar into your social life. It's no coincidence that my most successful guitar students that I've had over the last 10 years all go to guitar meetups, they go to group classes, they go to more concerts. They are really living the guitar life. They're a part of the guitar community. Okay, reason number two, scratching the surface. With all the information that we have out there, all the resources, the thousands and thousands of YouTube tutorials, for example, I find that a lot of students are just scratching the surface on many different techniques and not really becoming a master of anything. So one of the things I always recommend to students is to find something that you're really interested in learning and dig into it and really, really go after that. And don't quit on it until you really feel like you've metabolized the information, retained the information, and are able to put it to good use. Okay, reason number three, practicing sloppy. Over my teaching career, I've seen so many students unintentionally stunt their growth as a guitar player by practicing, number one, too fast, and also not paying attention to their technique. So I want you all to remember, for every single time you play something wrong, you're taking three steps backward. To become a good guitar player and a confident guitar player, it means that you're having very, very slow, methodical, and thoughtful practice. So slow things down and really pay attention to the quality of the notes that you're playing. Okay, reason number four, misguided focus. Over my teaching career, I've seen a lot of guitar players tackle projects, whether it be genres or individual tunes or techniques, that they're told will be good for their progress by other guitar players, or they just assume that it will be. One student comes to mind, he was a ska, reggae, pop fan, came to me asking for classical guitar lessons because a number of guitar players told him it was the only way for him to get good. The problem with that is he had never willingly listened to classical music ever in his life, and he didn't really enjoy the style of music. And that's a clear-cut path to quitting the guitar, because if you're not really in love with the music that you're playing, you're probably not going to be interested and you're not going to get a lot of fulfillment out of that practice. So my suggestion for all beginner guitar players out there is practice what you love, practice what moves you, and all the while keep a steady diet of good music and keep branching out. You may, over time, develop an interest in other styles. Okay, on to reason number five, bad equipment. Now, I don't care how good of a guitar player you are, doesn't matter if you're Derek Trucks or Danny Gatton, if you have faulty equipment, a guitar with high action or bad intonation, you're not gonna sound great, and worst of all, you're never gonna enjoy picking up that guitar and practicing. So I say this to all of my students, get your guitars checked out, make sure that they're good to go. If you're struggling with your guitar and you can tell something's wrong, upgrade and get something that's gonna allow you to move to the next level. Okay, now reason number six, and this one is very important to me. You're stressed out. And we all have very stressful lives. We have screaming kids, we have trouble at work, we have the 24-hour news cycle insanity fest that inundates everything. So one of the things I always tell everybody is that when you are having your practice time, allow that to be your time. Allow it to be something that relaxes you. So find a quiet place, no distractions. I have my my basement studio down here. I've got all my guitars. I'm stocked up with some craft beers, some great records. This is kind of like my happy place. So when you're practicing, make sure that you have that kind of a place, someplace completely free of distractions. Okay, on to reason number seven. You don't learn so good. Now what I mean by that is we're all victims of this cookie cutter education system that doesn't teach kids to teach themselves and consider what their learning needs are. So I wasn't able to make a lot of progress on the guitar until I actually sat down and kind of developed a strategy for teaching myself, a strategy for learning. And a lot of that was just kind of getting to know myself, measuring my strengths, but also my weaknesses, and then considering what kinds of things help me to retain information more. So some of the things I discovered are things that I've already mentioned in this and many other lessons, about practicing slowly, about being very methodical and focused, and also practicing in an environment that's free of distractions. But there's also small things like just the order in which I approach certain techniques, the fact that I always warm up before I ever try to learn anything, because my hands shouldn't be slowing me down and destroying my confidence because I can't get something quick enough. So I want you all to think about your learning style. I want you to think about the things that work and things that don't work, and over the course of many different practice sessions, really start to give yourself a game plan on how you can teach yourself a little bit better. Okay, on to reason number 8, missed learning opportunities. And some of the best information that I've ever gotten as a guitar player has come in the form of impromptu lessons at the strangest times and in the strangest places. Sometimes just randomly walking down the street, sitting in a park, at the music store, at a party. Whenever I hear someone playing something, I don't like to let that learning opportunity go. If it's something that I like, I'll approach that guitar player and chat with them. So that's just a little bit of advice for everybody. Most guitar players are very friendly, more than willing to share some of their secrets, and most guitar players love talking guitar. So the next time you hear someone playing something at the music store and it's something really, really cool, see if you can approach them and walk away with a little bit of information, a little bit of knowledge off that guitar player. And if you do that often enough, you're gonna put it all together, it's gonna meld into your own personal style, you'll be drawn from so many great sources and individuals that you've met over the years. Okay, reason number 9. A resistance to fundamentals. Now, I know so many guitar players, people that have been playing for years, that don't want to hear anything about music theory, and it really stunts their progress. I'm going to be the first person to tell you that it doesn't matter what you're trying to learn, whether it's entire tunes, riffs, lead guitar techniques, it's all infinitely easier to learn if you have a basic understanding of music theory. So I'm going to invite you to click up here in the top corner and take my basic music theory crash course. And then also I want you to take time, learn the notes on the fretboard. Learn your essential scales, like the major scale, the pentatonic scale, the blues scale. Those can get you so far. If you have a basic understanding of those things, wow, it's gonna make a massive difference in the rate of progress that you have. Okay, on to the final reason why you suck at guitar. Reason number 10, a lack of confidence. The process of learning something new, taking a technique, getting started, and seeing it all the way to fruition is difficult in itself. But if you have a lack of faith in your abilities, it's almost impossible. So what I suggest you do to build your confidence is take on small but manageable goals, see them all the way to fruition before moving on to anything else. In addition to that, treat yourself to learning something that is very simple but recognizable, something very riffy. This is a great way to build your confidence and make you feel like you're taking steps forward. Alright everyone, thanks so much for checking out this lesson on 10 reasons why you suck at guitar. I hope now that by watching this video, you have 10 ways of getting better at the guitar. I want to thank my patrons for supporting this channel and making these lessons possible. Head over to patreon.com/swiftlessons if you want to access tabs for all my popular YouTube guitar lessons. I got many more videos coming up, so keep checking back. Please subscribe, please share. This is Rob at Swift Guitar Lessons in Philadelphia, saying happy picking.